Dear students, the topic that I am going to cover is a part of the banquet. Today what we are going to talk about of the banquet function topic is SOP for banquet service sequence and briefing. This is what the agenda for today's class is. My name is Amit Gupta. I am assistant professor with the Chitkara School of Hospitality. So let's move forward and discuss about the today content. The introduction, or I would say the content or the scope for today's class, is introduction to the SOP, service sequence and briefing. We'll talk about briefing in depth and we'll talk about the service sequence. That is what we have planned. So let's move forward. The first agenda is introduction. We all know banquet functions plays a very important role in the revenue of the hotel and of the department. So let's move forward. So in the introduction, what we are just going to discuss what would be for the different slides is, before each function, the staff member in charge of the function shall brief all his or her staff member regarding the particular function. The following thing that is being covered in the briefing is, or briefing in the sequence, is the way the function will take place. Allocate tasks accordingly and fix time schedules for all the staff members. For larger functions, especially when casual staffs are involved, then a table plan is being discussed and who would be working where. Job allocation plan must be issued to all the staff members as well as to the casual staffs. Make sure that each staff member knows his or her duties and where to perform them during that particular function. If needed, a rehearsal time shall be organized, which is very important. Now, in the staff briefing, the following thing that is being covered are the room the function will be held in, very important, because if we don't know where the function will be held, it is very difficult for the banquet personnel to organize the function. The number of guests expected. Now here the number of guests expected talks about the minimum guest guaranteed and the maximum number expected during that particular function, so we could be ready for that. Table setup specification, including the sizes, types and colors of tablecloths and table skirts, are being discussed. The menu for the function, including beverages, number of courses and dessert to be served for that particular function, is being discussed and also elaborated. So the, in case the, any of the guests ask for how it is being prepared, what are the content of that food or the dessert, the staff members should be aware of that. Review time for guests will arrive. Food should be plated, serve each course, etc. The type of event or function it is, any special request made by the guest is being discussed out here. The other subject covered during the briefing includes employee personal hygiene, that is no body or smoking odor from the service staff, whether he or she, clean hair and fingernails. Uniform should be correct, complete and impeccable without any spots. Food service menu of serving operating equipment we should be aware of, which all being is required and we need to arrange before the function starts. Standard of service mentions the do's and don'ts of banquet service. VIP guest present and special guest request, if it is there, it is being discussed in brief with the staff members. A good briefing will avoid any service problem during the function. I hope we all agree with this. Now, when we talk about service sequence, let's move forward. Although the service sequence for the banquet department are basically the same as these for other F&B outlets, that is food and beverage outlets, they have to be adapted, prepared and if needed rehearsed in order to cope with larger number of guests. We all know in the banquet function, large gathering of people take place, so we should be aware of that, of the service sequence. The following thing that is being discussed in the service sequence are, when the organizer arrives at the hotel, he or she must be welcomed by the staff member who booked the event. So the event people, those who have booked the function, should be physically present when the guest arrives and introduces the guest to the banquet as well as to the other staff member, that is the assistant banquet manager. The person will introduce the guest to the assistant banquet manager, which I told you, in charge of the function. And together with the guest, the function seat shall be checked to make sure that everything is according to his or her order or requirement. The function room where the event will take place must clearly indicate the name of the function as well as the status in order to indicate whether the function is in progress or not. Apart from that, in the lobby also a board to read is being placed so that the guests are aware where the function is taking place, with the arrow signal indicating the movement point. Every staff member, especially all casual staff, must be informed about the selected service sequence during the briefing session before the function starts. Very important. During the banquet meeting and daily banquet briefing, all the steps of the service sequence must be clarified to everyone so that everyone is on the same platform and aware what kind of service and how the service need to be performed and what equipment would be required for performing that function service. The layout of the function rooms, that is the assigned areas, bar, counter and buffet, must be organized before each function, and everyone should be aware which location is meant for which purpose so that the easy going of the function can take place. All required equipment must be prepared and cleaned to ensure a smooth setup and service for the particular banquet function should be adhered to. I hope you like the presentation. Thank you. We'll again meet for another session that would be related to the banquet only. Thank you.